Coach Derek Mason enters his sixth season as the head coach for the Commodores, although last season he became just the second coach in Vanderbilt history to lead them to multiple bowl games. He is looking to take Vanderbilt program to the next step in the process. Last season, the Commodores finished the season with a 6-7 overall record. However, four of those losses were by a touchdown or less, and if Florida had not kicked a field goal with less than a minute remaining in the game, that number would be 5. The Commodores were competitive in several matchups against top 15 teams, including a 5-point loss to number 5 Notre Dame, a 10-point loss to number 7 Florida, and a 7-point loss to number 12 Kentucky, making their season more impressive than a 6-7 record would indicate. The two biggest concerns you don't want to have headed into the season on the offensive side of the football is at your quarterback position and offensive line. Unfortunately for the Commodores, they will be looking to replace their all-time leading passer, Kyle Schirmer, who completed 62% of his passes for 3,130 yards and 24 touchdowns his senior year. Vanderbilt has two options at quarterback in junior Deuce Wallace and the senior transfer from Ball State, Riley Neal. Even though I think Wallace has a slightly higher ceiling, I believe that Neal will be named starter because of his experience. Wallace missed all of last season because of suspension and never played a meaningful snap in his college career. Neal, on the other hand, has started 32 games while completing 60% of his passes and throwing for 7,393 yards. Vanderbilt will potentially have their best offensive playmakers in school history, and the coaching staff may not find enough time to develop a quarterback during the season. However, whoever wins the starting position will have a ton of talent around them, including the SEC's leading receiver, Kalijah Lipscomb, who led the SEC with 87 receptions with 916 yards and 9 touchdowns on the season. Not only will the Commodores' starting quarterback have the SEC's leading receiver, but they will also have one of the top tight ends in the country in Jared Pinkney, who had 50 receptions for 774 yards and 7 touchdowns on the season. It has been said that one of the best tools for a young quarterback is a great running game, and few programs in the country will have a better running back than Keyshawn Vaughn from Vanderbilt. Keyshawn ran for 1,244 yards last season and 12 touchdowns. He also led the league in multiple categories, including yards per carry with 7.9, the most rushes over 40 yards with 10, the most rushes for over 60 yards with 6. Keyshawn also led the SEC in yards after contact with 5.29 yards. That was over a full yard better than power back Elijah Holyfield from the University of Georgia, who finished with 4.09 yards after contact. If Vanderbilt wants to take the next step as a football program, they will have to improve dramatically on defense. Last season, the Commodores finished 99th in the nation in total defense, giving up 438.9 yards per game. Vandy has a ton of talent coming back, led by linebacker Demetri Moore, who was second on the team in tackles with 84 tackles. The Commodores should be much improved on defense next season, as Coach Mason has brought in several transfers that should boost the depth immediately, including Eddie Zinn Turner, the graduate transfer, Brandon Maddox, the junior college transfer, and former Wisconsin defensive back Dante Carrier-Williams to help in the secondary. Although the path will not be easy, I do believe that the Vanderbilt Commodores will win 7 games in the regular season next season. I believe that they will beat Purdue, Northern Illinois, Ole Miss, UNLV, South Carolina, East Tennessee State, and Tennessee State. That will give them an opportunity to win an 8th game in the bowl game this season. The most likely bowl destination for Vanderbilt at this point will be the Birmingham Bowl, where they'll once again have a chance to win their 8th game and participate in the 3rd bowl game in 4 seasons. Thank you once again for watching our Roku special of the Dr. SEC 2019 Vanderbilt Commodore football preview and predictions.